My name is Jeff Ament. I play music for a living. I'm in a band called Pearl Jam. I scored the music with Josh Klinghoffer and Josh Evans and John Wicks for Under the Banner of Heaven. The inspiration for this music started probably 25 years ago. I have a big room in the house. We built it so we could make ambient music, where we set up multiple looper stations in the room with small amps, set up with totally different effects pedals. We'd pick a key, and Josh Klinghoffer and I and Josh Evans would sort of go around to the looper stations, and if one was sticking out or if it was too samey, we'd go find a blue note. We would like just sort of tune the room, and then we'd get the volume really super quiet and to let the room really be the instrument for the music. Oftentimes we would have a bed that was going, and then we would pick up a xylophone and start walking around the room playing a melody, or somebody would sit down at the piano and just start playing the most basic two chord pattern, or somebody would start hitting a drum with just a little bit of a pulse. And oftentimes the rest of us would sort of fall into the thing that seemed like it was the coolest thing. I think the only thing about my background that prepared me for this project was the fact that I've been playing music for 40 years. I sort of come from punk rock, and so there's sort of a I can do anything DIY element to almost every piece of music that I've ever been a part of. The amazing thing was that the screenwriter, showrunner, Lance Black, he was the guy all along saying like, don't listen to anything else because I want you to do your own thing. I want you to go for it, get darker, get prettier. And that was such an amazing thing to hear every week from Lance. You know, he would talk in poetry in the way that he wanted things to sound, and talked a lot about the dichotomy between the heavy darkness of the earthly desires and the celestial and the shimmer of the heavens and just the battle of those two sounds. Initially we were sort of hoping that there would be more different musicians coming, but because of COVID we were just sort of like, okay, well we have to play all these instruments, and that's when it ended up that I started doing a lot of bowing on this baritone, because I could bow the baritone and a cello halfway and an acoustic bass, and I could sort of simulate stringed instruments. And sometimes we'd run through a bunch of effects and you could actually make it even sound more like a particular stringed instrument, like a cello or a violin. It was sort of the spirit of the whole thing was to like, well, we don't have a quartet here, so we have to make a quartet out of what we got.
So you killed her then? For daring to resist you.
Episode 2 was one of my favorites. I remember Lance saying something like, if you don't like knock them out at the end of episode 2, they're not coming back for episode 3. There's a loop of an that we grabbed and then we played over that thing and sort of crafted that whole outro too. It kind of has the heavies run through the forest, some great John Wicks drums, kind of about 20 seconds of this flurry that goes up to where the gun pokes out of the hole, and then it sort of stops and just lightly rings out, and then this guitar duet thing comes in, and I remember feeling like, okay, people are coming back for episode 3.